Togethia TV.
Hi, this is Farouk from Drift All-Stars, and this is the final round of the season, and this is the road to Malta.
Hello and welcome. Coming up in today's show, we have a bit of an international surprise for you. This year, Malta is hosting the drifting finals.
I'm Vince Knight with Adamotion.
I'm Tim Lowe from America.
I'm Filippo Pirini.
I'm George Muscat from Malta.
Hi, I'm Carl, and I'm here with the Supercar Club.
We're Team Maximum Lock.
Hi, I'm Brett McQueen.
Hi, I'm Max from Drift All Stars, and you're watching Road to Malta.
Togethia TV. Yay!
All good road trips start bright and early, so it's only fitting that we start at dawn at a sunny Jap Performance Parts HQ.
Last year we went over to Malta by road and we had such an amazing time, and Adrian and George put on such a good event, we thought we'd do it again. So we're going to drive on through France and then Italy, across Sicily and into Malta. It's now Tuesday morning, 7 o'clock, so we should be in Malta by Thursday night, 11 p.m. We've got the car ready, we've got the Forester STI this time. We'll make a nice trip, great car, load space, lots of power. We'll get everything loaded and we head off in a minute.
Right, we're all packed. It's about 7:15 on Tuesday morning now. The Eurotunnel crossing that we got booked is about 8:45, so we better get a move on.
It probably comes as no surprise that the motorways in France are not particularly breathtaking, so it was a good thing that the major tunnel connecting our route had been closed, meaning our second morning could be spent in a place that looks like this.
In a way, it's fortunate the tunnel was closed. We've just come through the mountain, parked up here, and look at that view.
Beautiful, isn't it?
It's amazing. In less than half an hour, it was warm, and it's now cold. There's snow up in the mountains here. It's amazing. It's about 4 or 5 degrees here now. But now I'm going to be heading back down, past a hairpin, down the road, and to the Gotthard Pass, and across up to Italy. Cinema. It's the round sound. about 11 o'clock now on Thursday, and we landed in Palermo this morning. It's a chaotic, noisy place, and heading east all the way across Sicily. Spend the day there and then head south, pick up the boat to Malta tonight.
So we've nearly finished our road trip, 1850 miles from the UK. We've driven through France, Switzerland, Italy, now in Sicily, in Pozzello. Just about to catch the ferry over to Malta. We met with one of the drivers, Filippo. How are you doing?
Good to see you, mate.
Yeah,
good to see you too. Big journey also for me. But
how many kilometres for you?
1,300 kilometers from my city.
So in a trailer, quite a trip for you as well then?
Yeah. Good. What's good, but not today about the trailer, because my tires.
So you lost the tire on the trailer?
I lost the tire on the trailer, so it was a little nightmare. So
you finally made it here. You're all set for this weekend?
Yeah, very excited, and I have to do well. I've seen on Facebook a lot of pictures about the organization, the track, the layout is very good, the position as well, close to the beach.
Yeah, it looks like a pretty stunning venue this year. Have you done anything new to the car since we saw you last?
The car now has maximum power and 350 brake horsepower now.
But it's a very light car, isn't it? So it'll do very well with that amount of power.
Yeah, it's a 870 kilo car. And to do well. My girlfriend here, so I'm really excited.
Well, I'm sure you'll do very well, mate. Yeah. Best of luck for the weekend.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Well, with 45 drivers in Hungary and 35 drivers here in Malta for this weekend, it should be a really exciting event. Don't forget to go online and check out all the details and see what's going on.
So after that amazing 2,000-mile road trip through all the different countries, through the boot of Italy and over to Sicily and now straight to Malta, we are here at round six, the final round, which will decide three guys, super tight, fighting for the championship, and one will take home the crown. So let's get to the action.
Hold your horses, Farouk. Before we cut to the chase, Saj has met up with a customer to find out if his parts went to good use.
Tarsi, great to see you again.
Hi, Saj. Great.
Last time we met was in the UK, back at my shop.
Nice.
And then you told me all about this Escort.
Yes.
I've come to Malta to see it. Tell me all about it.
We've done a special project on it. We've done it four-wheel drive. We use the Skyline gearbox. We have about 650 brake horsepower on it. With nitros.
You guys are passionate about these cars, aren't you? Can I hear it running?
Yes, of course.
Only in Malta. Another first for Malta is an inspired amateur drifter all the way from India.
Well, I've started learning drifting a little while ago, and Malta's having this event. They've got an amateur category. So they asked me if I'd come down and drive in it, so came down to participate. It's a nice atmosphere, it's a great way to get some time in the seat.
And how long have you been drifting for?
I started this summer in May, June. On the tarmac I've got only 3 or 4 days of experience.
And compared to the other forms of driving that you enjoy so much, how would you compare drifting?
I think it's a sport that's catching on, and it's really got on all over the world. It's a high adrenaline sport, a lot of smoke, a lot of fun in a controlled environment. It's awesome fun.
Drifting, being one of the only motorsports in the world that's judged, it's important that you guys understand how it's actually being broken down. So every judge has 100 points, 75 of that going to his designated criteria, and 25 of that going to style. Four different criteria, three judges. So this is how it's going to break down. Olaf, what criteria are you judging this weekend?
I'm judging the line, so I look at what line they drift, if they go run the wall, and the inner apexes and the outer zones. That's what I judge.
And it's important for both cars, especially in twin battles, when we switch from qualifying to twin battles, that the lead car runs your designated line. Is that not true?
Yeah, that's right. The lead car has to drive his qualifying line.
Absolutely, and that gives a kind of a standard for the following car so that he can attack at full pace, yes?
He has to follow.
Perfect. And our second judge, Mantas from Lithuania, tell me what you're judging this weekend.
I'm judging speed this weekend, and what I'm looking for is the highest average speed possible on this layout today. We're looking the highest possible like dragster style acceleration and then boom!
Straight into angle,
maximum angle. The closer to the edge car looks, the better, the higher points. So
I know we have a speed gun that's actually measuring the speed through the transition. Is that what all your points are going towards, or is it also that you're doing some of it by eye?
Basically, most of the points are gained by eye. Speed gun is more like a reference point to check yourself how your eyes work. Yeah.
Good. Well, let's move on to the third judge, Mr. Arkadiusz Dudko, Jordi from Poland. Tell me what you're judging this weekend.
I'm looking for the angle.
Okay.
Yeah, so big angle means big smokes also.
And so those that don't understand angle, it's how sideways the car is it not?
Yeah, how sideways car goes. And also I'm looking for a good transition, because transition should be quick, aggressive, not so lazy. And I'm looking for an angle.
And by transition, are you referring to going from one turn to the other, and this is the transition point, and you want it to be a snappy transition from one turn and then snappy into the other?
Yeah, I'm looking for aggressive, quick transition, not so lazy, because if the transition is lazy, the car gets slowed down, so yeah.
Now, that angle is 75% of what you're judging for. What are you looking for in that 25% that you're giving for style?
Smoke, sound engines, the style of the driver, how he act or she, and general how he looks, how the car and the driver looks for me.
And Olaf, to conclude about the style, did the other judges miss anything that you will be looking for in style?
Yeah, how look they are, how good they are, the looks of the girls who are drifting, it's also style, so no, running the walls, the smoke, how the car looks, all that combines, and that's the 25 points we gave extra.
So you guys hear it, the style essentially is where the character of the driver translates into the end product. And well, let's get to the qualifying points and see you guys later. Did you try to
tell you? The drivers and the teams have spent the whole day testing. What better way to let off some steam after a long trip? Did she try to tell you that she's your mother? Did she cry in front of you? Or did you get my letter? So
Maximum Lock. You're watching The Road to Malta on Togethia TV. Yeah!
We're here at round six, the final round of Drift All-Stars at Malta, and kicking off practice in just a few minutes. So, track's set up, ready to go. Let's get it going.
Today is the day drivers will dedicate to practice on the new track. It's a crucial part of having a good technique for the competition. Up first is Sean Spiteri. His practice run shows good angle but not much speed. And it is revealed that there may be a technical problem causing misfire. Juha Rintanen is another favourite in the series. Unfortunately, he has been set back with a major fault.
All right, we've got some screaming finish. Juha, let me know what's going on.
We've been fighting a lot with the engine, and we got it working. We changed the piston and everything, and everything seemed fine on the track. A huge amount of smoke and everything, and the lines were good, but I don't know why, but the bearings from the turbo are now broke.
Man, so you guys drove all the way from Finland, 3 days from Finland, yeah? Changed the piston on Thursday, you brought your own piston, changed the whole piston, tore apart the engine, and now the turbo's gone. Do you guys think you'll be able to fix it and get back out there for qualification?
If we get the parts from here, then yes, yeah, of course.
Well, good luck to you, and we'll see how it works out.
Thank you.
While the drivers are getting some seat time, we want to show you what a beautiful island Malta is. Malta has an incredible culture and history, and with backdrops like this, can you really be surprised? Person no stranger to beautiful scenery, having just returned from a driving expedition in the Himalayas, was Indian businessman, supercar club chairman, and accomplished racing driver, Gautam Singhania. Joining Gautam on this occasion was the supercar club events chairman, Dilip Joshi, known to his friends as DJ.
DJ, long way away from home. What do you think of the track in Malta and so far the event, and how's it going for you?
One of the most fantastic experiences we've had. It's something we've looking forward to, and we're so proud of what G has done.
Let's talk about his qualifying lap. I know this morning there was a bit of car issues, some water was coming into the intake, so the power was a bit off, but he seems to put that aside. And what did you see as a spectator when he was qualifying?
Well, we were all very, honestly, we had our fingers crossed, but all the three laps, qualifying laps, went touch wood. Somebody up there is watching him. He's got the blessings of the Almighty. Fantastic. And to see he's just started drifting. But you'll be glad to know he's India's first drifter. Number one drifter now. We're going to bring the sport to India.
That's great. And okay, I see this logo on a couple of your shirts, the Sports Combat Club. Is this your group? Is this kind of the group of guys?
Supercar club. We run a supercar club in India.
Okay.
Where we do events, track days, ice driving days. Now drifting we'll be doing in India.
Great.
And a whole lot of events. We went to the mountains, Leh Ladakh, 18,500 feet up there. We did that 2 weeks ago. So we do different events all under Supercar Club.
That's the way it goes. Well, you guys heard it from them, Supercar Club in India. And from us, out. See you guys later.
Malta has such a rich car history. It seems everyone has their own car store.
Keep on going, you just gotta fight it. Keep on going, cause it's not...
I'm Moir Galia, and when I'm not driving for Team Mexico Block, I'm running the Malta Classic Car Museum. Come, I'll show you around.
Well, the museum has been going from 2005. Previously, my father had
the collection started years ago, and he ended up getting this great idea to do the museum and has it happened as a tourist attraction. One of my favorites, the 14 Aloto Smart One. It's one of my favorites because it has a history of racing. It's a fantastic rally car. It's great to look at and it's great fun. Of course, my collection wouldn't be complete without one of the Scoobies here. As you can see here, this is my father, at maybe 5 years of age, sitting on a Austin A40 Somerset. I was going to buy a Subaru from UK, and I asked my father to join. He bought a magazine, and he'd seen a Triumph in a picture, and he saw a front end of the Austin A40 Somerset. We ended up buying the car, because my father really wanted it, because he had one exactly like it. We brought it back to Malta, we done research on it, and we found that it's the same one that my grandfather previously owned, and has the photos of. So that is one of the most spectacular stories we got. Now it's back to drifting.
Team Maximum Lock are showing off some of their pedal skills to a home audience. This is refreshing, seeing as they've spent a large amount of their time in England this year. During practice, it's not uncommon for drivers to twin with each other. It's a good time to battle without the pressure of the competition. And on this occasion, Brad McQueen is paired with Martin Richards. Effort from the pair, as this replay shows Brad stays nice and close, and Martin taking a good line on the way out.
Guys, phenomenal showing so far this weekend. You're so aggressive here. Is there something that you're kind of punching for? Is there something to prove?
I've just had a bit of an away season. I've done a couple of other events and I want to do well here. I did well last year and I'd like to do similar again, so really pushing this weekend. I've got good tires, I've got my Achilles tires under it for this weekend as well, and looking forward to having a good time.
And tell me a bit more about this car that you've created, Sash.
This thing started off 3 years ago as a bit of fun, as a project, and then suddenly turned into a full competition pro car. When Walton joined us 2 years ago, it turned another leaf, and now it's just an amazing sensation, this car. Seeing it out on track yesterday and tonight, you know, made me so happy again. We've had a lot of issues this year, and it's really on form, and it's flying.
All right, Jet Performance Parts, keep an eye out for them. And thank you very much, gentlemen. Have a good luck to you over the weekend. How you doing, Brad?
Not bad.
How's the weekend been for you so far?
Really good, yeah. Feel fluent with the car for once.
Really? Okay, good. And tell me a bit about how the track's treating you. What do you think you get better at, and what do you think you're doing really well?
I think I'm linking the track really well. The line's right, but I just need a little bit more angle. Just push it out to the wall. I mean, to be honest though, I mean, I've been twinning with Walton Smith, I've been twinning with Martin Richards, and I mean, like, I've been sitting on them, so it's been all right. But this track's a lot better for me because it's a lot more flowy.
any changes for the car for this round, or is it pretty much the same as it always is? It looks really reliable and strong. It seems to be putting the power down now.
As you can see, we've put the Ouch Tattoo Studio logo back on the side of the car.
And the car's looking the part. Man, I mean, it really, I mean, with the graphics, I mean, Ouch Tattoo just really gives a good design to the car. Do you think you'll change up the design for next year, maybe a new design from Ouch?
The car's going to change design, definitely. I think we're going to go, a whisper rocket bunny, but I don't know.
All right. Well, best of luck to you over the weekend, buddy, and good having you out here as usual.
Yeah, man. Cheers. I'm enjoying it.
See you soon. All right. Concluding day one. Just finishing up practice right now. Tumultuous day. I mean, a lot of surprises in amateur qualifying. One of the guys that has only driven four times in his life, probably one of the best qualifiers of the day, coming all the way from India. Yuha blowing a turbo. I mean, it's been emotional. Engines rebuilt, now different parts blowing. We're excited to see how this leads into day two. So, concluding day one, there's a lot of hope for day two, and see you guys tomorrow.
We're supporting Jap Performance Parts, and you are watching the Road to Malta on Togethia TV. Yay!
There is a mystery driver in a 350Z on track. It turns out he's part of the reason why we're here in the first place.
So tell us, George, a little bit about this event.
This event, it's looking good. It's the finals. It's something new for Malta. It's, actually, it's the first international event that's been held here in Malta as a finals.
Today is the big competition day. What do you expect to see?
We expect to see the spectacle and the entertainment part of the drifting, which will be more competitive, and the drivers will give the utmost what they can and their cars can deliver.
The crowd is given a demonstration by one of the season's leaders of the kind of thing the judges are looking for.
So, full throttle down the line. This is the early. Oh my gosh, this is going to be the wall. Whoa! And ladies and gentlemen, that's why he's going to lead into the championship. Bravo to him, and let's get started qualifying.
First up, it's Luis Lopez in his Silvia S14 with a V8 conversion. Luis has been rubbing the wall all weekend, but in this run, it appears he's only warming up. Next is our Italian hero, Filippo Perini, in the nimble MX5. He has had a major power boost since last year, and this will speak volumes against the more powerful competition. Current championship leader, Alan Sinek, gets on track in his Silvia S14A. There is a livery similarity to Luis Lopez. If you haven't noticed, the pair have been sponsored by Nexen this year. And that's why he's the competition leader, a strong demonstration of line and speed. The first significant accident of the day, Peter Barber takes the line a bit too close to the wall, clips right. The back end and transfers the inertia into the front of the car.
God damn, it's not too bad.
It's alright.
What do we got wrong with the front? High rod?
Yeah, it's not over the brake line.
Alright, so minimal damage, probably get it fixed in a bit and get right back out there, right?
Yeah, it should be the same as the next 14, so hopefully we can just make one up sooner.
Alright, there we go.
Juha Rintanen, probably the fastest driver in the competition. Time and time again, he shows remarkable control of the JZ-powered Silvia S14A. tons and tons of smoke. I imagine his shoes are putting out some of the smoke as well, judging by how hard he's hitting the accelerator.
So we just saw some of the action in practice, and let's go check out what's going on with the drivers. I know some guys had a couple accidents and are still having some car issues, so let's go check it out. Was that Scotty or G driving last?
That was me.
That's good to hear. Hey guys, what's going on with the car? I mean, wow, it looks like it's hot out there, isn't it?
Very, very hot. Yeah, the car's doing really well. It's hanging on in there.
And so the comparison of the two drivers, G, how are you feeling in the car?
Oh, I'm feeling good this morning. I'm just keeping it safe. We got the competition, we got to save the car for both of us. So.
Absolutely, I mean, that's the responsible thing to do. And yourself, are you saving it for the two of you?
Oh, absolutely, I was just taking it easy. Can you not tell?
Fantastic. So in that battle, I mean, how's the speed of the car? Does it look like, does it feel like it's getting the traction that it needs to?
Yeah, it coming down, I'm having to really back off with Walton, but it was Walton's first run, so he was taking it easy. But yeah, I think it has. If I hook third up across the middle, I should be able to catch the guys. So,
so on the way out, you're hooking third. So you, okay. That seems to be one of the more technical parts of the track.
Yeah. I just tried it once there for third, and it just managed to carry it. So if I can do that and get the traction, I should be able to keep the fast boys.
And guys, I mean, I've been looking at this car over the weekend, and it's actually got a kind of a new character to it. It's a, you know, like how women love the guys with the scars. I mean, I think this has kind of gained that persona. I mean, I know you're building almost a bit loud from here. You're building almost a replica of this car. Tell me why you did that.
Well, I tried Scotty's car. It's a very nice bulletproof car, and then we decided to go with this as a, you know, as a good practice car. Which will look at the way she's holding out.
Yeah.
Touch wood. Just keep it going through the weekend. So.
Well, best of luck to you both, and some consistent driving from the both of you, and good luck. Now I know you're relaxing a bit. You had a, I know you and Alan have had a rivalry going on pretty much throughout the season. Can you tell me what happened in practice today?
Yeah, just as normal, the two of us, I was chasing him and everything was fine. I was quite close to him. Before the finish line, he decided to just back off. So we hit him and then all of a sudden he decides to reverse into me twice. So I don't know what's going on there. I don't know really. You know.
But if, you know, it might be a bit of frustration, maybe?
Well, he needs to take that out somewhere else then before he gets here, doesn't he? Like,
not on your bumper. So tactics for the weekend. I mean, I know you guys are fighting for the championship, both you and him. I mean, does your driving change? Are you going to be, I know you're the Iceman, you are Mr. Consistent, but are you going to be pushing harder, and especially if you meet Alan?
You know, I drive the way I drive, you know, I'll be on top of whoever is in front of me, you know, while I'm chasing him. Twin battles is where we do well, and, you know, this year we've been, we've upped the game a bit, and yeah, you know, we'll see where it goes. Just hold no prisoners, man, that's the way you have to do it.
And that's, I mean, I think that's why you have such a huge fan base and why people love watching you drive is because it's entertaining every single time you're out on track. There's no games, there's no BS, so to speak. It's just putting it all out there. Well, best of luck to you, and hopefully you get the car fixed quick enough.
Cheers.
See ya.
Thank you.
How you doing, buddy?
Okay.
Go ahead and tell me your name.
Chris Borch.
And, okay, so you've been part of MDA for years. Tell me a bit about, like, how long has this organization been around?
About 2 years ago.
And I know you guys struggle with a few tracks. Is this the first time you've drifted all year?
This year, the second time. This year. We need a track to break this.
You guys progress so quickly when you, I mean, I saw you 2 days ago driving here and the difference is amazing. How is it for a driver? I mean, what have you been working on in the past 2 days?
I work on the steering, how to feel and like that.
Maybe a bit of track time is needed?
Yes, we need it.
Do you travel outside of Malta for drifting as well?
About 1 year ago, I go to Sicily to practice some in a big track.
So you guys definitely need the tracks at home just because of...
Yes, we need it.
And tell me a bit about the car. It's a S14. What's the power?
It's 250 brake.
Almost standard, almost stock?
Standard, a little bit. So, good.
Yeah, well, best of luck to you in the next qualification session.
Thank you. Yep.
So now we've been doing amateur practice, and now we're going to move on to the amateur finals. And what that consists of, it's the same format as amateur qualification, where it is a single run setup. But the best 14 from last night are going to move on to the finals today. And the top three guys are going to podium, of course. So single run format, the top three are looking for trophies.
The Maltese Drift Association are on track now. It is worth noting that a lot of these drivers don't have access to a formal race circuit, so this is a very impressive display, bearing in mind they have only had a few days practice. Take a trip to my house, now there's what it seems. My life is like a roller coaster, drift inside a dream. Now I'm winning my place, see I'm winning getting down. It's a twisted castle, but inside I'm with a crown. Amateur finals had some surprising results. Gotham Singania, a man who couldn't possibly call himself any less of a local, walked away with his head held high. Not only did he earn his country's first pro drift license, he also won the amateur finals. Take a trip to my
house. Hi, I'm Carl, and I'm here with the Supercar Club, and we're all here to support Gotham Singania. And you're watching The Road to Malta on Togethia TV.
So, we just finished up qualifying. We've got a surprise actually today. We've got Luis Lopez in first place. Phenomenal driver, just been getting so much better over into the season. You know, he came out to the first round with his championship winning car, which from Spain, which was, to be honest, a little below par for Drift All-Stars. And then the second round, he brought out this V8 monster, you know, the V8 S14. And it's been a teething season for him. You know, he's been getting better and better and better. And qualifying first, phenomenal. Changing things up, we don't know what's going to happen. You know, three guys, these three that you saw right here, they're fighting for the championship. Second, third, and fourth place qualifier, all fighting for the championship within 30 points of each other. So it's going to be interesting.
The first two competitors in the top 12 are Martin Richards leading, driving the JZ-powered Sora, and Walton Smith following in the Nissan RB26-powered Subaru.
That is...
Martin takes a very strong first line, and Walton catches up and maintains his pace. Plenty of smoke from Walton. A slightly shallower angle from Walton here, but his gap does shorten towards the end. Now, remember the competitors swap places for their second run so the judges can make the best decision. Walton leading very well, even generating a gap on the transition, but Martin closes it and keeps it very short. That is what sways the judges' decision in favour of Martin. A very close call indeed. Martin goes through. Next up, Filippo Perini versus Peter Barber. Filippo's MX-5 generating a huge gap at the beginning. It may cost Peter his position this early on. Filippo's power to weight is almost untouchable. Neither competitor generating that much smoke. That will cost a pair of them. A slightly better line by Peter on the way out there. Second run. Filippo hot on Peter's heels. A little bit more smoke now. Good transition, although the gap is quite wide. Filippo closes it very quickly. Very strong line by Peter. They both keep up a lot of speed through the clipping point, but entering the transition, Filippo keeps the gap short, which takes him through to the next round. Anthony Scott versus Brad McQueen. Anthony has been suffering from engine problems all day, and it looks like he still has them. He's shut down on his first run. You are permitted a short time to fix your car, and it looks like he has. Very shallow entry by Anthony. Brad looking very good into the first transition. Anthony straightens up here. His points will suffer for that. Let's see if he can do anything to bring it back. Brad is very fast through the clipping point. Good final clipping point by the pair, but it's not enough for Anthony Scott. Brad Lightning McQueen goes through. Luis Lopez versus Filippo Perini. Luis leading in the S14, a brute compared to the small but agile NX5. Lopez generates a good gap and delivers a bit more smoke than Filippo, who is no doubt working very hard behind the steering wheel. Through the clipping point into the transition, onto the wall, they keep up a lot of speed. Luis desperately trying to shake Filippo, but the brave Italian keeps hot on his toes, albeit for a small correction at the end there. Filippo leading now. The first clipping point, a huge gap is generated by Filippo. He needs to keep that speed up for the transition. Luis trying to close it up, but loses a bit of his angle now. But right behind Filippo, in fact, Luis has a bit of a better angle into that point. Into the transition, the gap widens again. Filippo pulls away the final clipping point there. Sadly, not enough, however, for the brave Italian. Luis goes through. Nigel Culver versus Sean Spiteri. Sean has been suffering from misfire issues all day, and his 13B engine is notably down on power. Colfer generating a huge lead into the clipping point. Plenty of smoke from veteran Colfer. Spiteri actually hitting the wall there, very aggressive driving. Colfer keeping the gap with lots of speed into the final box. Spiteri very shallow. That will probably cost him this run. Spiteri leading now. Let's see if he can recover into the first box. Nigel is hot on his tail right away. Spiteri keeps a very clean line through the transition, but the lack of power is taking its toll. Spit of flame there indicating the misfire. Through the transition, Colfer keeps the aggression there. Sean can't find the power he needs to pull away. Colfer almost overtaking Sean there. Nigel Colfer smashing his way into the next round. Juhar versus Martin. Both very fast competitors, but as you can tell, Martin Richards struggling to keep pace with the unstoppable Rintanen. Juhar, oh, moving so fast, he may travel back in time. Let's hope he doesn't choke his great-grandfather in the vaporized tire smoke he's generating. It seems as if only a miracle will save Martin against Mr. Fusion-powered S14. Chasing him now, Juhar on the brakes a lot through the transition. Plenty of smoke, but he isn't used to driving so slow. Martin takes a very clean line. The gap shortens. Juhar unbelievably spinning out. It appears the Lord doesn't like time travelers. A wonderful victory for Martin Richards, the underdog. Next up, top eight, Brad McQueen versus Alan Sinnott. This equally matched pair entering the transition. This may decide the victor. If Brad can keep the speed up, Sinnott will undoubtedly open the gap, which he has. Brad deploys the police lights trying to get Sinnott to pull over, although he's not calling for that one again. Sinnott taking a very hard line to the transition. A superb line by Alan there, but Brad unfortunately a bit shallow. Let's see if Brad has any tricks up his sleeve. Alan right behind him, a very clean transition from the pair, but still no smoke from Brad. Alan feels obliged to produce smoke for the pair of them. Brad flicks very well for the transition out towards the final tipping point. Sinnott, lots of smoke, but a tad shallow, but clean nonetheless. Looks like Lightning McQueen has had his thunder stolen by a triumphant Alan Sinnott. Luis Lopez versus Nigel Colfer. Two fiercely aggressive drivers. Luis painting the wall purple. Colfer thinks it should be battleship grey. Colfer in Lopez's footsteps, although the two still can't agree on the colour scheme, and one thing the pair do agree on is that they both should be in the next round. Nigel catching up with the smoke, but they are both very well synchronised through the final box. It's hard to tell. Let's see what run two brings. Colfer leading, setting a good pace. Grey, purple, Colfer, Lopez, neither can decide. Colfer shredding his tyres to pieces, Lopez closing the gap all the time. Into the transition, Lopez actually seems to have a better line. Lopez has the gap close to zero. It's a tough call, but Judges decide Lopez purple is the colour they want the next round to be painted in. Alan Sinnott versus Martin Richards. Another pair of well-matched drivers, Sinnott's S14A, giving the crowd the smoke they and the judges crave. Although Alan takes an impressively close line through the transition, Sinnott mistaking our cameraman for a clipping point, very impressive nonetheless. Richards is stuck to him like glue into the clipping point, again very hard to judge. Martin taking the lead now. Taking a better angle through the transition. Sinnott isn't letting go without a fight, however. I think Martin is quite happy to kick his own ass, ditching the bumper perhaps to improve power to weight. Sinnott actually a little straight there into the final box. Sinnott hugging Martin all the way around. And that is the deciding detail. Sinnott goes through. The fight for third place, Colfer and Richards. Things are getting pretty heated now. Colfer's approach gives him a fantastic angle into the transition. Nonetheless, initiates hard, inches from Colfer, though, although he was a bit slow through the clipping point. Now into the transition, a bit of a gap. Colfer's speed is excellent as he powers away. Lots of smoke. Richard leading now. Roaring into the first box. Colfer, oh, barely missing the wall. Richards takes a good line. Colfer is right there with him. Colfer very close to Richards. Both so fast into the final box. Colfer takes it by a landslide. And now, what everyone has been waiting for, the battle for first place. Lopez and Sinnott, the Nexon brothers. Sibling rivalry at its most hardcore. Have it. Alan Sinnott is this year's victor.
Final round of Drift All-Stars in Malta. Winner of the event, winner of the series, Alan Sinnott. Number two, Luis Lopez. First podium finish of the year. Qualified first, got on the second position in the end. What a phenomenal season. And here we are on this picturesque track with beautiful people. Can't wait till next year.
You know this woman, Pete?
No. I could be his manager, but I'm going to make a sign up here. Princess Pete's Pictures.
I'm Chris, you're from Drift Hosters, and you're watching Road to Malta.
What is it? Let's go past Mile.
Can you film it?
The guy.
Put that in there.
I take it another time.
Good.
This action!
I don't know what to say about myself, bitch.
I'm saying, I'm Farouk, I'm amazing, yo.
I'm Farouk. I'm amazing. No, I'm not gonna say that.
Read it, see it, live it. Only on Togethia TV.